Welcome everyone to SmackDown, and we are continuing the road to Money in the Bank with more qualifying matches here tonight. The team of Lacey Evans and Charlotte Flair have been unsuccessful in back-to-back championship tag team matches, and tonight they are hoping to bounce back into championship mindset with two qualifying matches for the both of them. Lacey Evans will be having a one-on-one match with the Queen of Spades, Shayna Baszler, and Charlotte Flair will be going one-on-one with the Empress of Tomorrow, Asuka, in qualifying matches for the SmackDown Money in the Bank ladder match. And we'll be also having a number one contender match for the Intercontinental Championship. Last week, Dakota Kai, the NXT Women's Champion, defeated Ember Moon, the Intercontinental Champion, in a Money in the Bank qualifying match, but it was after the match where Dakota Kai set a trap for the champion and Raquel Gonzalez led out Ember Moon in the middle of the ring. And tonight, can Mia Yim get back into title contention, or will Raquel Gonzalez dominate her way to the Intercontinental Championship? And in our main event, two of the confirmed Money in the Bank ladder match participants will be in action as the NXT Women's Champion Dakota Kai will go one-on-one with the Genius of the Sky, Io Shirai. And we're kicking off SmackDown with the Money in the Bank qualifying matches. Lacey Evans and Charlotte Flair will be having back-to-back matches here to see if they can make it to the ladder match. Last week, it was Lacey Evans and Charlotte Flair in a rematch championship tag team match with the new champs Tony Storm and Shotzi Blackheart, but were unsuccessful. Lacey Evans was in that match for the majority of the time, taking the damage, and at the end, it was Charlotte Flair that leapt off the apron and didn't help out her tag team partner in capturing the gold. It seems as though the two egos of Lacey Evans and Charlotte Flair are colliding quicker than we thought, as Lacey Evans faces a tough task in the form of Shayna Baszler.
The Queen of Spades, Shayna Baszler, a superstar who simply loves to break down her opponents no matter the circumstance. In a cage, in the ring, it's all the same to her.
Yeah, Baszler, just a sadistic competitor. She takes a sick sense of pleasure in beating down her opponents and systematically and methodically deconstructing them.
Byron, if Baszler has her way, no doubt we'll see her do just that here tonight.
And with Lacey Evans, you have a superstar who seems more concerned with appearances than she does in-ring antics. But do not let that fool you. Lacey Evans is about as dangerous as they come with a mean streak to boot.
Yeah, Lacey Evans is the picture of discipline in pinup model form.
Ruthless.
Quick pen attempt here.
Raising the shoulder way too early.
Ouch.
Evans with the retaliation. Getting set up for something in the corner. Setting them up. Arm is trapped. Pump handle. Slam. All measured up. Ah, drop kick to the spine. Reversal. Can they go on the attack?
Oof. And a finger snap.
Technique on display against Baszler.
Beautiful athleticism.
Hurricane Rana. Corey, you've seen Shayna Baszler run roughshod in both NXT and WWE. How exactly do you counter that dominance?
For as dominant as Baszler is, wow, wiping that smug look right off her face.
Trying to chop her down with a low kick.
Oh, quite an effective counter. Things taking a turn for her now.
She can withstand the punishment, though.
Oh, he's punishing the right arm.
Charlotte Flair is up on the apron, having words with Lacey Evans, trying to encourage her, tell her what to do. Either way, it is distracting Lacey Evans as Shayna Baszler taking advantage with the roll-up and gets the win. Shayna Baszler is heading to the Money in the Bank ladder match. I mean, it's sort of unclear what Charlotte Flair's intentions were by getting on the apron to have words with Lacey Evans, but ultimately distracting Evans, and Shayna Baszler is making her way to Money in the Bank. And there's no time to dwell on it as Charlotte Flair is facing Asuka next. If we remember, the alliance between Lacey Evans and Charlotte Flair was made on the basis that they would benefit each other, and as of late, they haven't been successful as a team, making it to the finals, yes, at Extreme Rules, but unsuccessful in capturing the tag team gold with the two opportunities they've had. And it seems as though tensions are flaring up between the two. More so with Charlotte Flair. But as we move back into qualifying matches, Asuka is here, as she has been having a slow and steady start to her time in Universe Mode 2K22. Asuka is still riding the wave of that huge win at WrestleMania over Ronda Rousey, and she is looking to get back into title contention, the former Raw Women's Champion, looking to get that Money in the Bank briefcase.
You have Charlotte Flair here, a talent who eats, sleeps, and breathes this business, and does nothing but train endlessly.
Well, you would think with all that training on the top rope and her abilities and natural athleticism, that Charlotte wouldn't have to rely on bullying tactics and mind games and shortcuts. So much better.
Byron, I really don't think Charlotte so much has to rely on those things as she prefers to use them. After all, she learned everything she knows from the dirtiest player in the game himself.
And then there is Asuka, who has proven time and time again that she is as dangerous a competitor as it gets in WWE. I can't think of anyone with a more piercing offense at their disposal.
Saxton, you're right that she's dangerous, but she's not invincible, especially in a post-undefeated streak.
Oh no, she could be caught here. Bad situation for her.
I'm gonna tap out here, but it ain't gonna matter. Nice escape. Flair gets that turn back on her.
Five!
She makes her way back in under the ropes.
And the hip attack finds the mark. Quick thinking pays off. There's Asuka set hard to the outside. She slips outside. What has she got in mind?
Holy meet the barricade.
Two.
Drops the hammer.
Right on the lower back.
She's feeling the hurt here.
Charlotte able to steer clear.
For Ware in the corner now.
A series of kicks in the corner.
And Charlotte with the reversal.
Asuka timed that one well.
And responds with a counter of their own.
Of tomorrow.
It could be over here!
This is it!
One, two,
no! Just got the shoulder off back yes. Out of it. Boom! What a slap! An overbearing assault on Charlotte now.
Charlotte needs to find a way to reverse her fortunes.
Charlotte showing how much punishment she can withstand before pushing out some of her own.
The U-turn Charlotte needed in this match could have been that right.
Well, in that match, Lacey Evans was giving the same response to Charlotte Flair, jumping up in the apron, trying to distract, and Charlotte Flair was a little bit unfazed by it, but it definitely got in her head as Asuka is heading to the Money in the Bank ladder match, tapping out the Queen. Well, now it is time to crown a new number one contender for the Intercontinental Championship. Ember Moon, coming up short in that qualifying match against Dakota Kai last week, will be defending her Intercontinental title at Money in the Bank. Dakota Kai has certainly bounced back from her losing streak by defeating Shayna Baszler and defending her title, so Raquel is looking to follow in her footsteps and get some championship gold to add to her arm as well.
Raquel Gonzalez out here now, and she's quite the commanding presence. Does whatever she wants, whenever she wants.
The towering Texans come looking for a fight, and she's getting one come hell or high water.
And tonight, Corey, I expect she's going to use her size and strength to bring her opponent to their breaking point.
But across the way, she'll have to contend with the HBIC medium. Do your sensitive ears even know what HBIC stands for, Saxton?
I do, but I'll paraphrase its meaning. It means Mia Yim is all about taking charge and delivering knockout blows. She's about bringing her street toughness right to her opponent's face.
Left by the turnbuckles.
Working over the midsection, attacking those ribs and organs.
Yes, boom, nice. Consecutive attacks keeping Mia off her game.
Mia's on the wrong side of every exchange.
Mia Yim, the self-proclaimed head baddie in charge. How does her opponent ensure that Yim doesn't take charge of this match?
Well, the HBIC earned that nickname by fighting hard, so you'll have to summon the will to fight even harder. Be the NHBIC.
Power slam. Cover. She kicks out at one.
She still has enough energy for a simple kick out.
Gonzalez was scouted there.
Kick to the midsection, sunset flip.
Now, into a powerbomb.
Smart strategy, attack the knee.
Gut-wrench suplex.
With that soul food. That is Mia Yim backing up her words, letting the opposition know who's in charge. Running STO blitz.
Nicely done.
Submission.
Oh, that looks like a torturous position to be in.
Oh, look at this. Is she gonna tap? Oh, look at this power. Incredible power from the position she was in.
Caught square by the haymaker.
German suplex.
Oh, look at this. Trapped now in just that.
Submission.
Ugh, twisting the body.
It was just a matter of time. She had nowhere to go.
Well, there we have it. Raquel Gonzalez is the number one contender for the Intercontinental Championship. She will be facing Ember Moon at Money in the Bank, trying to follow Dakota Kai's footsteps. But here's Ember Moon trying to get revenge from last week's attack over Raquel Gonzalez. Ember Moon has been fighting her way to find her place here on the SmackDown roster as the top champion, getting Mia Yim out of her way, and now Raquel Gonzalez is the toughest challenge that she has to date, as Raquel is storming out of the ring, trying to evade the attacks of Ember Moon. It is the main event. We are having a match between the NXT Women's Champion Dakota Kai and the Genius of the Sky, Io Shirai. Well, fun fact, Dakota Kai has been holding that NXT Women's Championship for over 110 days. And if we remember back in 2K20, it was Io Shirai's NXT Women's Championship that she won at the Evolution pay-per-view in a fatal four-way match. So Dakota Kai was the successor of Io Shirai, so the history is there between the two. And tonight we're having the first preview of what it would have been if Io Shirai kept her eyes on the NXT Championship.
She won't allow herself to be embarrassed this early on. Beautiful athleticism. Hurricane Rana.
Incredible athleticism.
Choke slammed right into the knee.
Oh, that might have just broken something. Solid contact there. You know, Io
from the middle rope.
Oh, she misses the mark. Oh, my goodness. Body slam. That'll turn your lights out. Looking bad for her here. She still has a lot of time to recover, though. Oh, the knee drop connects. Penny predicament, shoulders down.
Definitely looks in a hurry to finish things.
Just hot shot it to the outside. Outside of the ring now.
What's the plan here?
Sliding back into the action. Returning to the ring now. Oh, God. Dakota seems unable to turn the momentum here.
That quick energy of Shirai has Kai overwhelmed.
Down face first. Dakota wards off the attack. Boom! Thanks for cover. She flips it back on her.
Whoa! Drop kick all the way to the outside.
She wants to take this one outside the ring, it seems.
Well, despite capturing that gold from Io Shirai at the Evolution pay-per-view last season, Io Shirai gets the better of Dakota Kai in one-on-one action. As the Genius of the Sky is building huge momentum heading into Money in the Bank. And, well, here comes the champion, Sasha Banks. She is out here to attack Io Shirai, but Io is getting the upper hand of the champion. These two have some unfinished business after the historic WrestleMania winner takes all match. It is the reason why Sasha is two belts Banks, and Io Shirai has not been happy on the SmackDown roster. But here's Naomi out here to even the odds in a way, protecting and saving Sasha Banks from a further attack from Io Shirai. Naomi is in the Money in the Bank ladder match as well, so she has the same opportunity to become Miss Money in the Bank and capture the SmackDown Women's Championship from Sasha Banks. But Naomi is out here protecting the champion to close out SmackDown.